transportation, those are national solutions. The mayor just proposed in his budget 9.6 increase, tax increase on residential tax.
Sure.
We still have the 10-year tax abatement for new construction.
That's right.
There is a creation of two separate cities, especially in your district, where that, how that will adversely affect poor populations, that rent will go up and that tax increase will go to people on fixed income. And then you're like really pushing on them, yet people are sitting in McMansions in certain parts of the city that are valued at $400,000, $500,000 and not paying any taxes.
Well, the poor people are footing that bill. But you're right, and I'm just gonna defer a little bit.
Yeah, I can respond to that actually if you want me to.
You go ahead, John.
So if you listen to the mayor's plan, right, there's something called the homestead exemption, which is really powerful, which we passed up in Harrisburg last year. They're gonna make sure that the poorest people who are in those homes, that are residential homes, don't get hit, so they're capped on the level of increase.
That's homeownership.
So don't, exactly. So don't let anybody scare you about the fact that they're gonna be disproportionately impacted. The homestead exemption helps them more than anybody else. So if you look at what the mayor proposed in that increase, if what Governor Wolf has proposed in his tax structure change and what we want actually happens, people will get a reduction in their taxes after their second year. So they'll get hit the first year where on average, their property taxes will go up $100 or so a year. Think about that. Less than 30 cents a day. Wouldn't you pay more than 30 cents a day to fund our schools? I know I would. So that's what the mayor's talking about. He's talking about all of us across the city, based on his increase, paying 30 cents more a day to fund our education system for a year, so that we're back on track. The second year, they save money. So what you're seeing is, you know, not government asking you, we're gonna jack up your taxes and do whatever we want with the dollars. We're saying that increase is gonna be specifically targeted to educate our kids. You're gonna pay a little bit more in your first year, but your second year, it's gonna go down. To me, it's.
How does that play into equity for people who don't have children but yet benefit from all the infrastructure in the city?
That inequity is there across the country. So no matter where you live.
But doesn't mean we have to accept it.
Well, because it is universally accepted. People who don't have children benefit from a great economy and great students who are well-educated, and they hire them for jobs. So just because they don't have a kid in the school system, doesn't mean they don't get the benefit of a great educational system. That's a false choice, right? Whether you have a kid there that you're directly paying for and your taxes are specifically impacting that school district, or whether you're living in a community where the poverty level is better, where crime is better, where the unemployment rate is better, your real estate will go up because you live in a better community overall. Everybody benefits when our kids are more educated, not just the parents who have kids in school, all of us.
Yes, we create a better labor force.
Totally.
You know, with all due respect, Mr. Negative 18, let me just say this. And to your point, let's just hypothetically pick a family that owns a home, lives under the poverty level. How that person, explain to me how that person's gonna be able to pay those taxes at the end of the year if those taxes go up.
Or a person that's renting.
Or a person that's renting.
Right.
So we have to be realistic in what we're doing. And I think with all due respect to the mayor, increasing that, that's not feasible. That's not sustainable. And especially when you have a 27% poverty rate in the city of Philadelphia, how do you sustain that? How are you factoring these people in that equation?
Yeah,
you know,
here's how you do it. Here's how you do it. Because the answer is, then how do you pay for it? Because every other majority jurisdiction in the country funds their educational system out of property taxes. And we don't.
But their tax system is different.
So here, exactly.
Their tax base is different.
But the point of this is to change the tax base. That's the whole point of what we're doing. So if you think about it, and you're in Philadelphia, try looking at the taxes across the river in New Jersey for your property. They're double what they are in Philadelphia. Try looking at your taxes in Montgomery County. You wanna be surprised about why we have better schools in those communities than we have here? Because they pay for those schools with their property taxes.
Don't you have a median income that's twice that in Philadelphia?
Yeah.
And some of those people, by the way, who are gonna be in those poor communities, if they are owners, renters won't see the hit on a tax, their landlords will.
The landlord will.
And he may pass that along, he may not. But the truth is that those people, if they're benefiting from the homestead exception, will not see that significant of increase because they'll be capped. So that's the goal, and it's a balance. Look, in communities that are disproportionately hit with poverty rates that are incredibly high, right? Leslie and her constituents have to work really hard to make sure that that property tax system, whether it was ABI or what the mayor's proposing now, nobody was out of their home based on ABI, right? There were programs put in place to safeguard because nobody wants a little old lady to lose her house because her taxes went up 4 or 5%, right? That's the key. Those safeguards are there. And if you have those issues with the city, we have conversations around those issues all the time to work out all kinds of payment plans. So when your average, 30% of the people in the entire city saw an increase during ABI, and that meant 70% didn't see an increase. And of those people, the average increase was only in the hundreds of dollars, right? Some people can afford that, some people can't. To me, that's an investment, whether I'm poor or rich. The worse my schools are in that neighborhood, the more that I want to contribute to try to make that difference. And are some people going to struggle? Absolutely. So it's a balance for us to use safeguards, whether it's the homestead exception or the other safeguards, whether there's a veterans exception or whatever that happens to be. The abatement piece is a good conversation for us to have, which I think you're hearing in the mayoral race, right? People are talking about that. Because there are some neighborhoods where I think we need to have almost like enterprise zones, right, to encourage development and growth in some of our poorest communities. And I don't know that we're doing that the way we do it around
Providence. You have a question?
Yeah.
The way we should.
And